Welcome to Feed Dump, where we are now solar powered, which would be helpful if we ever went outside. I'm Graham, just Graham. Joining me this week is Paul Diesel and Creepy Kathleen. And the three of us will navigate this river of silly on our news canoes. In England, a tanker carrying 20 tons of Marmite-bound yeast extract overturned and spilled onto a highway.
It's the world's least tragic tragedy.
Oh no! We could have a worldwide Marmite shortage! Actually, come to think of it, we could actually be in a worldwide Marmite shortage, and I don't think anybody would notice.
Paul, is there an angle to this story other than we're not English and therefore hate Marmite?
The accident occurred when the tanker collided with a motorhome.
I can imagine there's a guy, you know, on the motorhome having his breakfast, being like, this toast seems kind of dismal. It really needs something to add a little extra. Oh my! And then just gets showered in yeast extract.
Showered in yeast extract is my guar cover band.
Grossest death ever.
A group of scientists has determined that babies as young as 8 months old not only dislike antisocial people, but enjoy seeing antisocial people punished for their actions.
Children, they're shitbags before you even know they're shitbags.
It's that they learn from such a young age to actually rejoice in the suffering of another person. I find that a little disturbing.
The testing was done with puppets, either acting good or bad, and when asked to give treats to the puppets, the babies rewarded the good puppets, and they also enjoyed the puppets who punished the bad puppets.
Have you ever been to a puppet show? Of course you like the puppet with the big stick that whacks the other puppet. That's the funny part.
Harvard scientists have built a new type of flexible robot that can wiggle its way through tight spaces.
Finally, a robot that can limbo. This is what we've been missing.
They built this just for the anal probing, didn't they?
Alright, so it's a soft, flexible robot to squeeze into tight spaces.
Robot Santa!
That is not where my mind went with that.
Well, I mean, we could go back to anal probing, but I think I've really explored the depth of that joke.
So to speak.
Robo Santa looks like a sandworm with a Santa hat on, and he's twice as terrifying.
In the annual Christmas parade in Chestertown, Maryland, a man dressed as Frosty the Snowman was arrested for arguing with police and kicking a dog.
Frosty the Snowman was a drunken, angry man. He yelled at some cops and kicked a dog, so they threw him in a van.
So the obvious question is, was he supposed to be Frosty the Snowman and then gave up and got drunk, or was he a regular dude who got so drunk that he thought dressing up as Frosty the Snowman was a great idea?
He might have just meant to be Santa and grabbed the wrong costume in a drunken stupor.
My hope is that he stayed in character the whole time. Hey, I'm a jolly happy soul. I'm magic hat, and I can laugh and play.
Woo!
Fuck you. Scam artists in Florida have been arrested for... been arrested for convincing a whole bunch of old people that they needed to buy special toilet paper because otherwise it would ruin their septic tanks.
I wouldn't make fun of old people for being taken in by a scam like this, but as someone who's lived in the city my entire life, septic tanks are strange and uncertain for me. You have to do stuff like put yogurt in them, you have to like feed it, and then there's certain things you're not allowed to put in. If somebody said you had to put in certain kinds of toilet paper, I would probably believe them.
Those who bought products from these men were put on a, quote, idiot list for follow-up sales.
Well, I can't really fault them for that, because while they could have named it something a little less damning, that's just common business sense.
I didn't think of it. I'm just remembering the last couple of telemarketer calls I got. I think I may be on one of those idiot lists.
What does our new correspondent think of this story? Well, we can find out in our new segment, Let's Ask What Is Clearly a Cardboard Cutout of Vin Diesel.
Let's ask questions of what is clearly a cardboard cutout of Vin Diesel.
What do you think of people who try to defraud the elderly?
Vin Diesel is a man of few words.
Well, that's it for this week. On behalf of Messrs. Saunders, Devere, Diesel, and Dahl, I'm Graham, and until next time, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat, because we recently bought it. It's ours now.
What is this supposed to be? supposed to be teaching the children.
Bad touching.
It's working.